Hey, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another Genshin Impact video, guys. Today we're going to be talking about constellations, especially for the new upcoming character Eula. And let's just get straight into the video, guys. If you have not already, consider subscribing to my channel if you guys want to watch more videos like this, as well as like the video if you enjoy the video. Anyways, constellations with Eula. This is, I guess, a hot take. In my humble opinion, no character in the game needs constellation. None of them need a constellation. Constellation should always be seen as just an additional factor to a character. It should never be seen, oh, you have to have this character multiple times. If you have one constellation of a character, this character does not become nullified. So yeah, if a character does not have constellations, that does not mean that the character is obsolete. It does not make the character any worse than it is. If you have constellations, it improves your character. Yes, 100% improves it by a ton. So much so. But you have to invest a lot into it. And some people can't just, you know, invest their entirety of their Prima Gems on a character, because new characters are going to come out and they're going to want those characters, and they want those characters' constellations or whatever it may be, in my opinion, because there are so many good characters. Zhongli, amazing character, amazing. In my opinion, the best in the game. It's like, do you want to use him as a character? Do you want to use other characters? Do you want the newer characters, you know, the flashier one? It's all up to, you know, preference and that type of thing. And that's something that's sort of, you know, keeping you locked down and keeping you sort of unable to get constellations. That's it. You don't need a character's constellation. For example, this is my second account, guys. This is not my main account. So me getting this constellation on chill day with one multi is the most insane thing to date that I've done. Nice for me to have a constellation of a 5-star character that I use, but it doesn't do much. Okay, for example, this constellation sucks, you know, decreases the CD foul legacy by 20%. And this kind of sucks. I don't really care, to be honest. I just use him for like 15 seconds while I'm on the field and then leave anyways. So this doesn't really matter at all. But for a character like Eula, she's rumored to have good constellation, especially if the constellation, you know, improve your talents and stuff like that. Everybody has a constellation that improves talents, for example, this. In my opinion, yes, that is excellent. Yes, that is good. You always want to improve your talents, but you don't have to. You really do not have to have that extra 3 talent push, because you can get your character leveled up. You can get their talents leveled up. Yes, it's going to take a lot of investment. It's going to take a lot of time and effort. But rather than you spending all your Prima Gems on the same character, on the same banner, risking all your Prima Gems to try to 50-50 the character, it's hard to balance or put on a scale what's more worth it. Saving your gems for newer characters or newer banners, or reruns of banners maybe, or even the weapon banner if you guys ever want to summon on that. It's kind of hard to make a scale in which you could see, oh, summoning on them and getting a constellation is better than summoning on them and getting a weapon, a 5-star weapon, for example. It's really, really difficult for you guys to make a call on which one is better. I'm talking about Eula here. So anyways, her constellations are going to be very centered around her kit. So it might have to do with cryo or physical damage. Actually, it might most likely be physical damage. And you wanting to improve your physical damage is great. It's really good. But you guys have to remember, you have artifacts. You should use artifacts to improve your physical damage, because those artifacts exist. You can use the Bloodstain set, you can use the Pale Flame set, which I'm gonna use on my Eula. I'm gonna use the Pale Flame set. And that improves my physical damage. Yes, it won't improve it by like 100% or 200%, but it's still gonna improve it. I'm making this video just so you guys know that you don't need a constellation. You really don't need a constellation for her. Yes, she's going to be incredible, she's going to be even better on Eula, but you don't need it. So if you guys are ever deciding, oh, I have to have Eula, Eula is a must, okay, you can go for her, but you don't need multiple constellations of her just for her to be good. She can be good without a constellation. Any character can be good without a constellation. So just keep that in mind. A lot of people think all constellations make or break a character. I truly believe that constellations do not make or break a character. A character's kit makes or breaks a character. The character can do multiple things at once, you know, bring a lot of support to the team, bring a lot of sub DPS to the team, be the main DPS. That type of team balance, the team synergy, that's what you want to look for in, oh, how good is a character. You know, constellations are really cool, but you don't need it. You really don't need it. For example, this is Zhangling. First constellation, pyro resistance reduced by 15%. This is going to greatly increase your pyro damage to another unit, or an enemy, or a boss, or whatever it may be. This is going to help, but you don't need it. If you level up your character's artifacts, you level up their weapons, you level up themselves, that's going to help you do the damage you need. You don't need to have a constellation. I mean, that's all I wanted to talk about in this video, why you guys should or should not be summoning for a constellation. Obviously, I myself might go for one constellation on Eula. That's just because I really like her. And don't get me wrong, I might think, oh, I don't need a constellation on Eula. I'll just go for a five star weapon. This will all depend on the four stars that are going to be on the new banner, and I heard that the new banner is going to be pretty good. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys do enjoy this video. I know I kind of rambled a lot, but I hope you guys did enjoy. Anyways, Eula does not need constellations. That's my opinion, that's my take, and I hope you guys give me an opinion based on that in the comment section down below. Let me know what you guys think, because I'm really curious about it all. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. Hope you guys do enjoy. See you in the next video. Goodbye.